social development and technological change go hand in hand, and the ways in which we were, from a theoretical basis, conceptualizing that process was in terms of the acquisition of capabilities of different kinds.
Well, I think the urban aspect of the application of technology is fundamental. I mean, one of the things we're seeing in low and middle income countries, and in particular in African countries, is very rapid rates of urbanization and cities which are growing very, very quickly. So the economic future of these countries will be dependent on how capable the cities are, these major cities are, in adapting to new technology and enabling the whole cross-section of the population to be able to use technology in improving their economic circumstances.
When we were looking at Tanzania and Indonesia, we conducted research in a number of ways into what would be the enabling environment, what would be the institutional strengths and weaknesses, to try to assess what you can tell from that kind of data about whether innovation is taking place.
It's a challenge not just with technology or industrial development, but economic development generally, that it's still something that sits within the remit of, you know, the National Ministry of Economy. And I don't think governments in countries which are changing very quickly have policies that are sophisticated enough yet to understand the role of the city, because it's the cities that are generating more and more wealth in countries because they get bigger and they become more substantial components of the national economy.
Other side of technology too that I think is sort of underappreciated too is the political economy, or the politics that underpins it. Another aspect can be organizational failures or implementation failures. We saw this with things like citizen feedback projects, mm-hmm. which have been successful in some countries and not in others. So Pakistan is an example, and Punjab, where there were successes, and Indonesia, arguably, not so much.
I mean, one would like to think that technology will ideally accelerate the diversification of the industrial base of cities, but also the diversification of the who is involved in the economy. I think one of the challenges in some cities is that, you know, the economic participation is concentrated among certain types of residents of the city. It might be to do with ethnicity or culture or gender. And I think technology can enable more people to be involved in the economic life of a city.
In the context of cities, a theme that we hear again and again is this idea of urban resilience. Mm-hmm. Could you explain what you mean by that and what the role of technology might be in mm-hmm. understanding it? Mm-hmm.
It's really about the ability of cities to withstand certain types of shocks and to continue operating in the face of having to deal with shocks, and ideally to kind of bounce back in a stronger way post-shock. And the kinds of shocks that are usually talked about are climate-related shocks. Quite often the response in policy terms is a physical response. It's about making the city physically better able to withstand rising sea levels, flood, overheating, etc. And that's obviously vitally important. But resilience isn't just about physical response, it's also about economic response, it's about cultural response, and it's about the ability of economies to continue functioning even though something is physically not going to work well for a while. And technology does play a role there. How can technology enable different types of industries which are important to a city to somehow keep functioning?